Dear students, welcome to the painting class. This is Manpreet here from the Millennium School. In today's video, we are going to learn one interesting topic, that is origin and development of Mughal art. So let's start with the today's topic. The Mughal School of Art. Its period was 15th century to 18th century AD. Mughal School of Art was not a new style in itself, but it was a same Indian school of art, which was well refined and polished by the Persian artist with the help of Indian artist. Actually, Mughal art is a mixture of Indian Rajasthani art and Persian art. So here I have one example. This lady is sitting, that is Indian art, and you can call Rajasthani traditional art. And second one is Persian art, and third one is Mughal art. Rajasthani traditional art plus Persian art is equal to Mughal art. In Mughal art, they used to make border with the Persian style. In fact, Mughals were very much impressed by the Indian style of art, but the general ornamentation and borders decoration was of Persian style. So now we'll see origin and development of Mughal art. The origin of Mughal school of painting is considered to be a landmark in the history of painting in India. A new culture of painting developed under the patronage of the Mughal rulers of Timur dynasty in Bukhara and Samarkand, and it reached its peak during the 15th century. Timur gave due regards and importance to the artist in his court. Vizard was the best artist among all the painters of that time. He basically was a Persian artist. He was known as the Raphael of the East. He was the greatest painter in the court of Sultan Hussein Mirza. After the death of this Sultan, Vizard took a job in the court of Safavid Shah Ismail. Vizard basically belonged to Timur dynasty. Timur dynasty was the origin of Mughal period. So here I have one chart of Mughal emperors. The first one is Babur, then Humayun, then Akbar, then Jahangir, then Shah Jahan, then Aurangzeb, and the last one is Bahadur Shah Zafar. So now we'll discuss them one by one. The first one is Babur. Babur became emperor in 1526 to 1530. Babur was from Timur family, founder of Mughal Empire in India. Babur was not only a brave soldier and an able commander. He also had a great liking for a painting. Babur was mostly in the battlefield and died in 1530 AD. So now we'll discuss about Humayun, the son of Babur. He became emperor in 1530 to 1540 and then 1555 to 1556. There is some gap because of Sher Shah Suri. Sher Shah Suri became emperor in 1539 of Delhi. Sher Shah Suri defeated Humayun in the Battle of Chausa and Kannauj in 1540. He had spent 13 years in exile in Iran after being pushed by the Sher Shah Suri from India. Sher Shah Suri died in 1545. Then again Humayun came back in 1555. Humayun was also busy in battles. He got one painting of Dastan-e-Amir Himaja done in his time. He had two famous artists in his court who they came from Kabul, namely Mir Sayyid Ali and Khwaja Abdustmand from Behzad School of Art. Humayun died in 1555 or 1556 AD. After ascending the throne of Delhi and left his son Akbar, only child, as his successor. Akbar became emperor in 1556 to 1605. It was the golden period of Mughal art. Akbar was 13 years old at that time. Emperor Akbar was keenly interested in the art of painting and architecture as well as sculptures also. Akbar was a man of great strength of character and had a broad vision. The Mughal school of painting was organized and reached at its zenith during this time. A large number of Indian artists from all over Indian world recruited to work in his court. There are many manuscripts that were illustrated in this time. Manuscripts that were illustrated in Akbar's time. The first one is the Tiwarik A. Khandan in Taimuria. The second one is the Rajmanama Mahabharat. The third one is the Ramayana, translated in Persian and painted. The fourth one is the Bakht Babri. Fifth one is the Akbarnama. Sixth one is the Anwar A. Sunali. Seventh one is the Ayaz Danish. Eighth one is the Nal Damayanti. Ninth one is the Changez Nama. Tenth one is the Zafar Nama. 11th one is the Ine Akbari. 12th one is the Hamza Nama. 13th one is Taimur Nama. And last one is Babur Nama, etc. According to the Ine Akbari of Abul Fazl, during that period, about 1400 events had been painted, out of which few are available now. Akbar had started a new religion, Deen-e-Alahi, the aim of which was the compromise or Sulah-e-Kul, peace with all. He became very popular in very short time because of his greatness. So here we have one list of the painters in Akbar's court. First one is Mir Sayyid Ali of Tabriz, Khawaja Abdustmand of Siraj. Third one is Behzad, Persian artist. And fourth one is Bagh. Fifth one is Miskin. The sixth one is Basavan. The seventh one is Manohar. The eighth one is Daulat. The ninth one is Mansur. The tenth one is Kesu. The 11th one is Lal. The 12th one is Shankar Govardhan and Inayat. The 13th one is Daswant. The 14th one is Mukund. And the last one is Jagannath, the fourth emperor of Mughal Empire. Jahangir, son of Akbar, was a great lover of art and nature. The Mughal miniature reached a very high level of excellence in his period. He encouraged his painters. As a result, a number of paintings were painted of birds, flowers and animals in his time. The portrait painting became very popular during Jahangir's time. Even we find some portraits of ladies illustrated in his time. Now we'll see famous painters of Jahangir's time. Famous painters of Jahangir's times are Ustad Mansur. He is a bird painter. Here you can see in one picture on the screen. This is a bird painting. It's done by Ustad Mansur. The second one is Abul Hasan, animals and portrait painter. Vichitra, symbolic painter. The fourth one is Bishandas, portrait painter. And the fifth one is Balchand. And the sixth one is Mukhlis. And the seventh one is Daulat. And the eighth one is Riza. And the ninth one is Bheem. And the last one is Inayat. Under Jahangir's patronage, painting acquired great charm, refinement and dignity. He had great fascination of nature and took delight in the portrait of birds, animals and flowers. The Anwar-e Sunali is another travel book in which short stories convey moral lessons. So now we'll discuss about Shah Jahan. It's a fifth emperor of Mughal Empire. After the death of Jahangir, Shah Jahan became emperor of the Mughal Empire in 1628. But he did not patronize painting like his father. He was a lover of architecture. He got so many forts, palaces and mosques constructed. The Taj Mahal, Red Fort of Agra, etc. The art of painting went on in Jahangir's style in Shah Jahan's times also. But the standard was not that high as it was during Jahangir's period. The art of painting saw a downfall in the time of Shah Jahan. So now we'll discuss about Aurangzeb. He is a sixth emperor of Mughal Empire. Aurangzeb came as a fanatic Muslim ruler. He was a bitter enemy of painting and music. Most of the artists went to hills where they got shelter, and after reaching there, they invented a rare new style of painting which is known as Pahari School of Art. In this way, the Mughal painting saw its end during the time of Aurangzeb. So now we'll discuss the last emperor of Mughal Empire, Bahadur Shah Zafar. During the period of Bahadur Shah, there was a revival of Mughal painting after the neglecting shown by Aurangzeb. The style showed an improvement in quality. After 1712 AD, the Mughal painting again started deteriorating under the later Mughals. Through retaining the outer form, it became lifeless and lost of inherent quality of earlier Mughal art. Finally, the glorious period of Mughal miniature art came to an end in the early 18th century. So we can say that Mughal art, organized by Mughals, developed by Mughals and ended with Mughals ruler in India. Hope you understood well about today's topic. So next session we'll continue this topic. We'll do characteristics of the Mughal school of art. So this is the end of today's session. Thank you.